Hey, welcome friends. CSIR exam is over and I hope you did well. So question paper was not very difficult. It was good question paper. Organic and inorganic part was very good. The questions were conceptual. Physical part was slightly difficult, but who prepared well, they can easily answer. And I hope all of you did well. So how was your exam? Let me know in the comment section. And I'm uploading the answer key for organic questions. These answer keys are only my opinion, and I am not telling that all of them are correct, but most of them are correct. And if there is any further variation or change in the answer key, I will obviously note you. So let's start the answer key video. So let's start with the part B. This is the booklet number B, and I am starting from part B, organic part. So this is the first question in this booklet, which is given. This is a reduction reaction, and I discussed the same reaction in my channel with Radel, and I also told that the same reaction happens with lithium aluminum hydride also. So in this case, if you reduce this triple bond, which is adjacent to a wedge group, you will get a trans alkene generally. But if you have added electrophile, that electrophile will add trans cis to this CH2OH group. So this will be the correct product, option A. In this case, the option 1 is the right product. Now this is the next question. In this case, it is the oxidation with MnO2, and you know that MnO2 generally oxidizes allylic alcohol, and if you do the reaction, you will find this option 3 is the correct answer in this case. So after that, this reaction is given. This is the Wittig rearrangement. If you don't recognize the reaction, you should recall your previous things. So basically, in this case, you have to decide where the anion will form. So there is a allylic position and one benzylic position. So obviously, benzylic position is more acidic. That's why deprotonation will occur from here. And in this case, the correct answer will be this one. Option 1 will be the correct answer. Then this is the reaction. This is the Birch reduction. And you know, in any substrate, reduction will occur on that nucleus which is less electron rich or electron deficient. So in this case, due to the presence of this nitrogen lone pair, this ring is electron rich, so this is electron deficient ring. So obviously the reduction will occur on this benzene ring, so that's why you will get option 4 as your correct answer. Then after that, this is just order of some nucleophilic substitution reaction. You know, more the more the electrophilicity of the carbonyl group will be, more will be its rate, or faster will be its rate. So in this case, the fastest reaction will be with acidic chloride, then acidic anhydride, then methyl acetate, and then acetamide. So option 2 will be the correct answer. Then after that, this reaction, this is reacted with potassium ferrocyanate, and second condition is oxidized. So in this case, the most probable answer should be this coupled product, and as later it is oxidized, so it is expected that you will get this quinoid product rather than benzenoid product, okay, because benzene form will be oxidized to this quinoid form. So option 1 would be the most probable answer, although there is confusion. Then it is given the mass spectra, and you know, if you have M plus 2 peak with 4% abundance than M plus, then obviously there will be bromine in your compound. So the correct option is bromine. Okay, so these are the organic parts, and there are some other organic questions also. So this question number 45, you have to tell the stability between these two. Now if you have only trans decaline and cis decaline, then obviously your cis decaline, trans decaline will be more stable, because both of these groups are equatorial here, whereas in one group is axial here. But in this case, you can see due to the presence of these methyl groups, either case the 1,3 diaxial interaction is same. So it is expected that A and B should have equal stability. That is, option 3 will be the correct answer. That is, they are equally stable. Then you have to predict what are their aromaticity. So obviously this has 4n plus 2 pi electron system, and it is fully conjugated, and both of them are planar. So now it will be aromatic, and it has 4n pi electron system, that is 8 pi electrons, so it will be anti-aromatic. So option 2, A is aromatic and B is anti-aromatic, this will be the correct answer. Now this is IUPAC nomenclature. You can just draw this molecule in your ChemDraw software and you can get the IUPAC nomenclature. There is nothing else. Now this is another question which I discussed in my channel, that what will be the order of SN1 reaction. Solvolysis reaction means SN1 reaction. I discussed the same condition with 80% ethanol. So basically in this case, more stable carbocation, which will give the more stable carbocation, that will do the first reaction. So C will give fastest, then A, then B. So C, A, B, option 4 will be the correct answer. Now it is a copy paste question, the ninhydrin formation, and this is the correct structure of ninhydrin. Option A is the correct answer. Then after that, this you have to predict number of NMR signals comes from this compound. So in this case, the correct option will be 6. 6 NMR signals will come. How it will come, I will, if you want to know, I will discuss later, but 6 is the correct answer. So option 3 is the correct answer. After that, I will discuss from part C. So in the part C, this question number 81, this is the Shapiro reaction, and after that the one electrophile in the form of formaldehyde is added. So basically you have to note from which side the deprotonation will take place, and as this is a basic reaction, BULI you are using, so obviously the most acidic proton will be deprotonated. So between this one and this one, this will be the most acidic proton. So the expected answer should be this one as A, and after that it is the Claisen-Johnson rearrangement, that is orthoester you are using. So Claisen-Johnson rearrangement will give you this product. So in this case, option 2 is the expected answer. Then after that, this is a question from NMR spectroscopy, and if you correlate with this NMR values, you will get option 1 as correct answer. This structure matches most closely with this NMR values, so option A will be the correct answer. Then after that, this is basically cyclotrimerization reaction or Wohlert cyclotrimerization reaction, and in this case this di radical will form, and after that this deuterium addition will give this product. So option 1 will be the correct answer. Then it is the solvolysis reaction, again solvolysis reaction, and you know if they are trans, then neighboring group participation can occur, and obviously after that the incoming nucleophile will also add trans to this group. So option 1, which says that A react faster than B and also give trans product, that will be the correct answer. Then after that, this is a cycloaddition reaction followed by electrocyclic ring opening reaction, and in this case option 4, which says that it is a 2 plus 2 cycloaddition reaction followed by disrotatory electrophilic ring opening, this will be the correct answer. Then after that, this is a very important question, which is a allylic substitution reaction with palladium catalysis, and in this case this will be the correct answer. Option 1 will be the correct answer, where your OH group and this large nucleophile, that is this group, both are on the same side, and after that the metachlorobenzoic acid epoxidation, that will occur on, from the same side where the OH is. So option 1 will be the correct answer. Then this is a reaction, Wittig reaction first, and in this case you are using the stable elide, so obviously it will give trans product. And after that, cycloaddition reaction is there, and the radioselectivity question, if you solve, you will get option 3 as your correct answer. Okay, so the relationship between these two are ortho relationship, that is they are adjacent to each other. Then next question is this reaction. This is a carbene reaction. First a carbene will form here, and after that either it can so basically CH insertion will occur into this carbene. So two possibilities are there, either 6 membered or 5 membered ring can form, but according to the Baldwin's rule, 5 membered ring formation is faster than 6 membered. So basically you will get option A as your correct answer, because sodium cyanoborohydride at pH 4, which is a very weak reducing agent, and that will reduce only that, so it is a chemoselective reducing agent. and it will reduce the group which is more electrophilic. So that means in this case the keto group will reduce. So in presence of ester you can reduce the keto group. So this chemoselective reduction will give option 1 as correct answer. Then after that, this is a reaction where first the nitrogen will attack here and it will form the acetate compound, and then this will attack, but the nucleophilic side is this one, and finally hydrolysis will give the carboxylic acid. So option 1 will be the correct answer. Then in this case, first epoxidation and then bromination. So final product you will get option 2. This product will be the final product. In this case, this is aromatic compound, so accordingly you have to choose what will be the NMR shift values for this particular protons. And in this case, option 1, this matching for P2Q1 R3 and S4, this will be the correct answer. Then these two reactions are given. They are aromatic substitution reaction. The first one is the benzyne mechanism, and in the benzyne mechanism the first step, that is the deprotonation step, is the rate determining step. So that will be favored when more electronegative group is there. So between iodine and chlorine is more electronegative, so that means K2 will be faster than K1, and in this case more the electrophilicity of the group, or more electron withdrawing is the group, more fast will be the attack of the nucleophile on that center. So that means the fluorine is most electronegative, so that's why K4 will be faster than K3. So this K2 faster than K1 and K4 faster than K3, this option 4 will be the correct answer. Then this is a rearrangement reaction or fragmentation reaction, and in this case option, this is a copy paste question from Clarion. So here you will get A as this product, and after that the sulfur elide will attack here, so you will get option 1 as the correct answer. This is a reaction of Diels-Alder reaction. This is the Diels-Alder reaction, so it will first give a compound where you have both double bonds, but now this palladium carbon with methanol solvent, it will reduce chemoselectively only that double bond which is not conjugated. So that means this double bond will be reduced, so you will get option 3 as your correct answer. Then question number 95, it says that irradiation with either cis or transcystalbene gives 93% cis and 7% trans olefin. Why this is so? Now the most probable answer should be the excitation coefficient of the transcystalbene is greater than cisstalbene at exciting wavelength. So that means at the exciting wavelength only the transcystalbene will absorb and it will convert it to the cisstalbene, and cisstalbene will be unreacted. So that means that's why you will get cis as major. So option 2 will be the correct answer. Now this question number 96 is little bit confusing, and it is basically Norrish type 1 reaction, and here this product you will get, obviously this product you will get, but then this option 1 and 4 in both cases this product is given, but the other product either it will be this one or this one, that is not, I'm not sure. So either 1 or 4 may be the correct answer. There is no chance of 2 and 3. Then after that this one, this is basically a very important reaction, and I am not discussing the mechanism, but you will get this as your first product, and after that as B you will get this. So finally aldehyde group will form here. This is a little bit confusing between this option and this option, but this will be the right answer. Option 1 will be the right answer. Then this one here, this pi, so you know this is a 2+2 cycloaddition, and in presence of this it says that it is thermal reaction, so it will be pi 2 s plus pi 2 a. I discussed it in details in the pericyclic reaction video. Then after that endo product will form more if the group is smaller, so it will be methyl greater than isopropyl greater than tert butyl. So option 3 will be the correct answer. Then this carbohydrate problem, and in this case this option 1 will be the correct answer. If you just draw the proper structure of the glucose, you will get the answer. Then for question number 100, you will get this option 4 as correct answer. There is no confusion. So these are the answer key for organic. and I will later upload other answer keys for inorganic and physical. And if there is any further change in the answer key, I will obviously tell you. So thank you for watching, and if you are new to this channel, so subscribe my channel.